Welcome. We've seen in the previous clip how sediments with high organic content are formed. Large molecules of organic matter called kerogen are trapped into the rock. However, if these sediments remain close to the surface where they have been deposited, no petroleum is created because kerogen cracking only becomes efficient when rocks reach a higher temperature. In the plot, two curves are shown, one for oil and one for gas, indicating the temperatures at which cracking of organic matter becomes efficient. At temperatures below 70 degrees, reactions are so slow that the rock rich in organic matter will produce no significant amounts of hydrocarbons. The rock is named immature. If the rock subsides at deeper levels, kerogen cracking will occur and hydrocarbons are produced. The rock is called mature. Oil generation reaches a maximum between 70 degrees and 100 degrees. This interval is called the oil window. When rocks subside even more, they acquire even higher temperatures, and production of oil will end. Rocks have become overmature. At the same time, generation of gas is still very efficient. The gas window is indeed deeper than the oil window. As you can see, determining the time-temperature evolution of the rock is of great importance. The hydrocarbon molecules generated during cracking will initially be stored in the source rock. Storage will mainly take place in microfractures and in the little porosity left after sediment compaction, and will continue until the source rock is fully saturated. How do we then determine if we have a productive source rock? Seismic images do not provide obvious answers to this fundamental question. The first step is then to predict the presence of a rock rich in organic matter at depth. This is typically done combining geological models, regional knowledge, and a detailed analysis of seismic data. The second step is to predict its thermal evolution. How mature is the rock? If at all, when did it produce hydrocarbons? To predict the degree of maturity of the potential source rock, you will have to estimate its temperature. To do this, you need to predict the geothermal gradient. If temperatures follow the red line, temperature of the sediment will be between T3 and T4, and the rock will be overmature. Too late, the rock has subsided beneath the oil window and no more oil is being produced. If temperatures are controlled by the gradient shown with a blue line, then the source rock will be at temperatures between T1 and T2, and the rock is mature and fully producing. Timing is important. If the rock enters the oil window before the trap is formed, then the hydrocarbons will migrate to the surface, forming seeps and being of little use. If, on the contrary, the trap forms before or during petroleum generation, then a substantial part of the hydrocarbons will accumulate in the trap, forming a reservoir. In the next clips, we will learn more about these processes.